Hello. The camera's like, I don't know what to track. Where's the human? I don't see it. Welcome back to another new video. If you guys have been following my channel, or if you saw a video I made like 2 weeks ago now, it was about how everyone seems to be going through burnout for some reason right now. And I kind of talked about it and I was like, I think a lot of people are just discouraged. Like, burnout is a pretty strong word. For today's video, I'm going to kind of show you how I make a content strategy for my channel. And I don't do this all the time. I might do this like once or twice a year. I swear there are sirens here like 24/7. Excuse me. If you're wondering why I'm like sitting down, it's because my tripod's broken and I can't make it go any higher than this. So on my, what should I call this? Audrey's content strategy list. That sort of works. I like writing things down and being able to put my thoughts into like something visual that makes sense I can refer back to later. But the first thing on my list is to choose your top three pillars of content. And I've talked about this multiple times before if you've watched my channel, but people will say like between 2 to maybe 5, probably more, like different topics is okay, but for me I think 3 works really well. It's just a little bit less all over the place than like 5 or more, but honestly it depends on the person. I've been meaning to vlog outside for some time now, but it's been so cold I just haven't done it. But like, look how cool this is. What's number 2? Hold on. Number 2 is figuring out your target audience. What I mean by that is like, who do you want to be watching your videos, or who do you think is the typical person who would be watching? For example, I like to think like really specific. So you can make up like a random person in your brain. Let's just name them Bob or something, okay, for the sake of this. Maybe Bob has similar interests as me, is learning about cinematography, filmmaking. Maybe Bob wants to make filmmaking or cinematography or photography like part of his career in the future. Basically, Bob is like me. Yeah, I think it's important to like know who you're making content for, or at least have a general idea, so that when you're, you know, talking to the camera, you sort of know who you're addressing. I can actually film here because there's no one else outside. Right as I say that. Where did he come from? Literally right as I say, oh, there's no one biking, it's too cold. But my third point is be able to describe your channel in like a sentence. I'm gonna keep checking now because I don't want to get run over. I had one written down in my notebook that's definitely a lot better than whatever I could come up with right now. But it'd probably be something along the lines of like making videos documenting my journey as a young creative to like teach as I go, to just document my experience along the way. And there's a bike coming. The next thing is letting people know like what they can expect from their channel, whether that's different series that you host weekly or monthly. It's important for people to know like what they can expect. Like, for example, giving all of my secrets away / spoilers for future videos, but I like to make like vlogtorials, so kind of stuff like this where I talk about a specific point. I have my I Try To series, which most of you are probably familiar with. A lot of you found my channel that way. So the last one is challenges / stories, which I plan to do more of. I already was gonna do one where I did one video a month, but that one kind of failed. Let's not talk about that. But I do plan on doing more challenges / like videos that are maybe short films or more story based. For example, if you're making cooking videos, a ton of people find your channel because of your cooking videos, and then out of nowhere you drop a skateboarding tutorial. People are probably gonna be confused, and it might cause them to unsubscribe or just not subscribe to you in the first place if they don't know what to expect. I gotta look at my list for some of these last ones. What were some of your favorite videos you made, / what were some of the most successful videos you made, and like what qualities do they have that you could continue, and then how can you experiment with different types of content with new video ideas, maybe something you've never really done before, but you've been like, I've always wanted to try that, you just never really did it. I was watching a video the other day, I'm forgetting who it's by, but she was talking about how making like videos is like data. But what I took away from that video was that it's important to experiment as much as possible with different types of content to see like what you like, you know, your priorities could be different. For me, I like to experiment with different types of content to not only like see what works best or what types of videos works best when it comes to the algorithm, but also just see like what I like to make and evolve my style as a filmmaker as much as possible. I think it's also really cool to find some creators like in your niche and seeing like, okay, what videos of theirs do I really like and how can I gain inspiration from that? Don't copy people. Hello, my nose is so red. I think those are most of my tips for creating a content strategy plan. I highly encourage you guys to do this yourselves if you're maybe a little bit lost with what you're doing, or this guy stopped literally right next to me. To do this, maybe if you're feeling a little bit lost with your content or you just don't know what direction to take, maybe you're feeling a little bit burnt out or you're feeling a little bit discouraged, here you go. It's a good way to kind of get your jumbled thoughts out of your head and onto something tangible. So yeah, I hope this video could help some of you out, sort of figure out a little bit more what you're doing, maybe help you get some inspiration, get your thoughts back together in a more clear and organized way. Either start a channel or get back into it. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment below with what are your three main pillars of content. I want to know, so leave a comment. And yeah, I will see you later this week with another new video. Bye!